to wax your surfboard. So there's a couple things I do that's different when I wax a board. People ask me, oh, Byron, how do you get such epic beads on your board? And so I'm going to show you that. I use state-covered wax. This is a hybrid wax. It's 70% organic. It's got a little bit of petrochemicals in it. You can find out more information on this at www.statecovered.com. And let me show you what I do. The first time you put wax on a new board, you're going to want to use a base coat or a tropical wax that's very firm and won't rub off very easy. And one thing I do to get the wax a little bit soft before I put it onto the fiberglass board is I take the bar of wax and I put it under my arm. And I let it just warm up a little bit while I'm getting my wetsuit, my leash ready. Give it a couple minutes so that the wax will actually get a little bit softer so it will bead up on the board better. When I start waxing, I start at the tail and I go in a diagonal pattern from the nose to the tail. Back and forth. Get ready and just repeat a little bit. First passes, I go an exact diagonal pattern the other way, from nose to tail. And this puts an even tension on the beads, so the beads will come in a better symmetry. So after you go nose to tail in a diagonal pattern, I'm gonna let the wax firm up just a bit. I'm gonna take the wax, put it under my arm, go get my leash, check out the waves, and let this firm up a bit. When you're waxing your board for the first time, it has to be in the shade. You want your board to be cooler than the wax. Now I've let the first coating firm up a bit, take the wax out from under my arm, and I start again, diagonal pattern, tail to nose. So after we go to the nose and tail, again we're gonna pause. We want the wax to get firm on the board. Take the wax, put it back under your arm again. Allowing the wax a little break to get firm helps it define better beads and it'll make the traction last longer. Okay, after about 6 or 8 coatings, the board should be ready to go surfing. You see a nice even bead pattern. And you can just come around, if there's any little bald spots, make sure you touch them up. But you should now have a nice consistent grippy pattern that you can add just a little bit of wax to each time you go surfing to keep it consistently grippy. Hey, it's Byron, 74 Surfboards. Thanks for watching the How to Wax a Surfboard video. Don't forget to subscribe to the 74 Surfboards YouTube channel. We've got new videos out every week.